The male gaze can be described as the act of depicting women from a masculine, heterosexual perspective that represents women as sexual objects for the pleasure of the male viewer. The male gaze was first introduced by feminist theorist Laura Mulvey in her seminal 1975 essay, Visual Pleasure in Narrative Cinema. In her essay, Laura proposes that sexual inequality is a controlling social force in the cinematic representations of women and men, and that the male gaze is a social construct derived from the ideologies and discourses of patriarchy. The male gaze has resulted in women being depicted as sexual objects where their values are judged by their appearance. Women are now often portrayed as submissive to men in films, advertising, and visual media. For centuries, artists have also been portraying women as objects for the satisfaction of the male viewer. A medium that has been used to portray women for the gaze or the male gaze is portraiture. For hundreds of years, portraiture paintings have not only been used to express status, but have been depicting fantasy-like women through their ideal and goddess-like bodies. Painting that serves at representing both status and what Romanticism would consider an ideal representation of a woman is the portrait of Princess Leonilla. The Romantic movement tried to break away from conventional painting and allowed the artist to paint from feeling and freedom of form. The portrait of Princess Leonilla is on display at the J. Paul Getty Museum in Los Angeles and was painted in the year 1843 by German artist Frank Xavier Winterhalter. Winterhalter was famous for his portraits of some of the leading members of the royal families. Winterhalter used symbolism, which was the use of signs to express relations and semantic constructions within the art to emphasize the social standing of those he captured in his portraiture. Princess Leonilla, a Russian-born princess, is painted leaning on a low Turkish sofa with her back overlooking the sea and distant islands. She is painted looking sternly at the viewer while playing with her large pearls around her neck, which reinforces the sensuality of her positioning. Even though her pose is similar to that of the harem scenes, her beautiful pearls and the detailed fan in her hand are symbolic of her social stature. Winterhalter's use of silk and deep colors are also indicative of her status, as dyes and silks were expensive commodities. Winterhalter's use of color against the princess's milky skin tone gives the painting an intimacy as though she's about to bare her soul. This engaging quality is what makes this portrait ideal for pleasing the male gaze. A painter that didn't conform to the ideologies of the male gaze was French artist Edouard Manet. Manet is a pivotal figure in art history and can be credited for the transition from realism to impressionism. Manet was known for sparking controversy with his exhibits, but was most famous for his controversial Olympia, painted in 1863. Olympia brought much debate because of the many details identifying her as a prostitute. Viewers were not fond of her direct, emotionless, and forward gaze because most were used to the highly romanticized portraits of women's bodies. Victorine Meurent was the model for Olympia and was well known in Parisian circles. She would have been recognized by viewers, and this familiarity is what made it shocking to some viewers. Another shocking aspect of the portrait, which is often overlooked, is the maid. While despite slavery being abolished, blacks were still not heavily featured in art, although she is still depicted performing house duties. Lorraine O'Grade argues it is not for artistic convention that Manet included Lori, but to create an ideological binary between white and black, good and bad, clean and dirty, and this allows whiteness to function as the only subject for consideration. Olympia is painted to the far left, reclining nude in bed while being brought flowers by her black servant. Unlike the smooth and perfect portrayal of Princess Leonilla, Manet's style of brushstrokes and pale flesh tones help emphasize her bulky body, similarly to how symbolism refutes back to Leonilla's social standing. Olympia's erotic pose and the positioning of her hand is symbolic of her independence by either giving or restricting access to her body. Much like the symbolism representing Princess Leonilla's status, certain objects were used to identify her as a prostitute. Some of these objects are the black cat, a creature associated with promiscuity, and items like her pearl earrings or even the orchid in her hair. The name Olympia was also a term associated with prostitutes at that time. At a glance, Winterhalter's portrait of Princess Leonilla has many similarities and differences to that of Manet's Olympia, but served to reassure both women of their wealth and influence in society. Although both women are portrayed in a similar position, it is still evident that one plays a more significant role than the other.